So thank you for being here. We're here to present Siniša Mihajlović, the new coach, whom we have a lot of faith in, so that the Milan team will take to the pitch as they know how to play as Milan have always played. Now, going back to last season, I personally believe that Milan were missing their real way of playing, the way that Milan have always known how to play, rather than playing good football and taking control of the game, which is the way that Milan have always played in the past.
Abbiamo constatato poi anche perché è venuto meno Torres in cui avevamo riposto.
Now we always had a lot of faith in Torres as well, going back to last season, and the other players as well. We had collected a group of players up front that we thought were very solid and very good. And just a little joke there about electoral campaigns, a slip of the tongue, but he said that a lot of money was spent as well last season on the players that were brought in. Now this season we decided to strengthen the front line once again. We initially were looking at Martinez, but we thought that the requested money from the club was a little bit too high. So we decided to look elsewhere for strikers, a Colombian striker.
Con Martinez di rincalzo negli ultimi parti del secondo tempo.
And we were able to conclude the new deal that we looked at, and we're very, very happy. Now he's just have to look at the name, because it's not easy to pronounce, so I have to look at it. In Colombian, they pronounce him. But I think in Colombia and here as well, we will call him Carlos. That's how we will call him, and that's how he will be known as. We also needed another striker, and that other striker is Adriano, Luis Adriano. We've been following him for a long time. He's a striker that has always scored plenty of goals, and we're also very happy to have concluded the deal with Adriano. Initially we thought he would arrive in January, but then we made another economic sacrifice, shall we say, to bring him in earlier, and so he will be arriving over the summer. Bertolacci is another signing as well that we've also concluded, because Roma had initially wanted to keep him thanks to his performances in the second half of last season. But in the end, we managed to convince Roma, spending a fair amount of money again, to convince Bertolacci to come to Milan. There are other names as well, new players. Gabriel is returning. He was the best goalkeeper in Serie B with Carpi, so he's coming back. From Avellino, Rodrigo Eli is also coming back. One of the best players from that team, from Avellino. Niang is coming back. Matri also is coming back from Juventus and Genoa, respectively.
dei nuovi giocatori su cui l'allenatore può contare.
And this is the group of new players that at the moment we have available to the new coach.
Che ha passato con noi sempre ad altissimi livelli. Ringraziamo Bocchetti.
We would like to thank Rami Bocchetti, all the players that spent time here.
Gli facciamo tanti auguri. Dovrebbe veramente riuscire a imporsi con le sue grandi capacità fisiche.
Rami is going to Sevilla, so Muntari as well is also leaving the club after quite a few years here. Essien, Van Ginkel is also leaving after a year on loan, and Pazzini is also leaving, and Destro as well. So we are handing over to Mr. Mihajlović a list of 29 players. Actually, that is 30 because Luis Adriano wasn't added to this list, and probably 31 with one more player to still be added. So now we have to reduce the squad to 25 players. So some more players will be leaving, and we will let some players go.
Abbiamo qua, come vedete, addirittura cinque portieri. No, come
we have here on this list that I'm looking at five goalkeepers, which is a few too many. We obviously are counting a lot on Lopez, who will be the number one probably. Gabriel as well, he's coming back because we think he's one for the future. And Donnarumma. Because everyone speaks very highly of Donnarumma, they say he's the new phenomenon in goal, and he's also another one for the future.
Quindi noi avremo la possibilità ancora di ritornare a 25, a cui vengono aggregati.
So we hope to reduce that squad to 25, and then some players. Seven players, to be precise, who could be added to the squad but are too young to really be classed as first-team players, like Mastur. We've got the best player from Monza, and Gori Calabria, Lucatelli, and Cutroni. Davide Calabria is a right back or left back, he can play either, and he's one to look out for. These are all new young prospects coming up through either the youth team or that Milan have invested in. These are the new things that we are presenting then to the coach.
The
last thing I need to add before I answer your questions is to wish Siniša all the best, and hopefully he will be able to work in the best of ways here at Milan. He has everything to take Milan back to the glory years. As we all know, football is made up of cycles. You have good moments and bad moments. Now we hope to return to the good times and to return to at least the Champions League positions next season.
Due parole sull'operazione di cui si è a lungo parlato.
Just a couple of words on the brand of Milan, especially abroad. We are trying to grow in the Asian market. We have more than 340 million fans around the world, and China is a huge, huge market for us. China has decided to take football into schools as part of a government operation. in many of China's cities, and so we think it is a market that is ready to be commercialized and to be to receive our brand. Mr. Touchball has presented a very interesting project to create a situation in China with our brand in the big supermarkets or in the big shops in China, to create a corner for Milan's merchandising, which we already sell here in our stores in Europe and in Italy, to bring the Milan brand to China. That could also include restaurants as well as other plans.
Riteniamo come previsione che ci sembra fondata possano arrivare dei fatturati.
And from this commercialization in China, say with the branding, we could grow in terms of the money that comes into the club and try to compete with the big European clubs. As we all know, the Arab states have come into football of late in the last few years and brought a lot of money into the new clubs that they have invested in around Europe, and it's difficult to compete with this kind of influx of money. So I don't think one family alone can compete with this kind of investment, the kind of investments that I have managed over the last 29 years with Milan.
So
it has been a huge effort on my part to become so successful here with Milan, and Milan have become the most successful club in the world thanks to the investments that we have been able to make over my presidency, having won the most international trophies over the world. So we enter this season with a lot of faith. It's a new season. There are lots of new prospects available. Now, going back to Siniša, there's lots of new players coming in, and it's not going to be easy for Mihajlović to be able to manage all these new players and this big squad now, but I think he is the right man for the job. It's obviously better to have more players available for selection than fewer players, so it's a good starting point at least for Mihajlović. I've also planned to visit Milanello today. We all will be, myself, Mihajlović, and Mr. Adriano Galliani. Mihajlović has promised that he will be at Milanello from early in the morning to very late in the evening, so I think he's well prepared. In order to do well, have to work hard and try our best. So I would just like to thank you for your attention now, and throughout the last year, which wasn't particularly fortunate for us. And we all know perfectly well that only Milan fans read your articles, and those Milan fans would like to be comforted a little bit more, and they would like to hear good things being written about their idols and not too many critics from your part, referred obviously to the journalists' hearing.
Anche abbastanza naturale. Io posso dirvi
From my point of view, I am a lover of football, you all know that. I have never read another article about another team. I read articles all the time about Milan and about the national team, but not about other clubs. I only turn my attention to my club. I don't want to look at other clubs or judge other clubs. So if you want to be read even more, now you know what to do. I don't know if Adriano wants to add something. This is the 30th season, the start of the 30th season for us. When the president speaks, there is nothing else to say, so I think we can go ahead with Mihajlović now, who might have something to say. So, first of all, good day to everyone. He's already started imitating the Pope. Joke from Mr. Berlusconi.
Nella mia vita nel calcio ho vissuto tante prime volte, ma questa sicuramente mi regala emozioni particolari.
Now it's a great honor to be here. This is a first for me, of course. It's a very special first for the club. The atmosphere here is extremely special. And I knew that already before coming here, but now that I'm here, I feel it even more so. I would like to thank the President, Mr. Berlusconi, and Mr. Galliani for having chosen me. This is a club with huge history. And having arrived here, not as somebody who has done things in the past with Milan, I'm not part of the Milan history, so I would love to, I'd like to thank both of them for the opportunity that they have given me, and I want to repay their faith, and the Milan fans, of course, by doing well. It's been a couple of difficult seasons for this club, and I will do everything I can to try and take Milan back to the top of Italian football. And I think that there are things in place to be able to do that. The club are working extremely well, especially on the transfer market. Three players are top quality players of the new ones that have come in. The president is doing everything he can to give me what I've asked for.
Diciamo non c'è oggi in Italia un progetto più ambizioso e più stimolante di questo qua.
Let's say I'm convinced that in Italy there isn't a more ambitious project than the one at Milan at the moment.
Sei destinato a pensare in grande.
Here you are destined to think big. You have to be ambitious, and you have to try and aim high. And the name itself is not enough on the pitch. You have to protect it. You have to respect it. He still hasn't finished, Mihajlović was saying, as Berlusconi was maybe interrupting. And so, I just want to say, in the era of the president, there are coaches that came through the Milan group, like Capello, Ancelotti. But there are those that came from outside as well, Zaccheroni, Allegri, and Sacchi as well, who changed the history of Italian football. I was not a former Milan player. The only way I can convince the fans is with my hard work. There is nothing that I have from the past that makes me a Milan person through and through. I'm going to have to earn that as time goes back.
Rispetto hanno saputo sempre incuotere ai propri avversari.
But I do know that Milan always, when we played them, they always were a strong team. They always were a fearful team to face. Other teams always had fear of playing against Milan, and that is what I want to return to. I want that Milan side. I want my team to install fear into other teams and respect from other teams. Our aim, which has already been told, which has already been said to you by the president, now there's a quote here from Mihajlović: we're going to be a team of devils with the red and black that will install fear in others. We must have faith. We must be optimistic. The president said to me that he's never known a pessimist that has done good things. So we have to be optimistic. We have to look ahead with optimism. And I am convinced, I am sure, if we're all convinced together, that we can become a great team. And that this year we can do really good things. I hope I didn't go on too long. Thank you very much, Siniša.
È quello di vedere concretizzato questo traguardo che ti sei dato.
We hope that this goal actually becomes a reality. I've always been an optimist. I still am. But I've also understood,
anni di vita vissuta,
thanks to the experience and the years that I have lived,
cosa sono certi pessimisti.
What certain pessimists are like.
Magari degli ottimisti che si sono informati bene.
They might be optimists who were well informed.
Restiamo assolutamente ottimisti e credo.
But anyway, we are going to remain optimistic, and there are all the ingredients in place. Everything is in place to be able to do really well this season, and we have a lot of hope for the season to come. So now, any questions from you? If there are any, we're willing to answer.
Buongiorno Presidente, buongiorno. Presidente, era il 16 luglio 86, gli elicotteri sono passati 30 anni, lo ricordava, 30 stagioni.
30 years have gone by since the helicopters flew in, 30 years that you have been in charge.
Primo giorno, e poi ricordo una frase un mese e mezzo fa che proprio lei ha detto a me: Ibrahimovic è una magnificenza. Il Milan è già competitivo.
Remind you of something you said to me about a month ago, allora, that Ibrahimovic is magnificent. I'm going to let Mr. Galliani reply about Mr. Ibrahimovic. Well, if he comes, we'll have him. That's not a problem. Ibrahimovic, because he's a great player. And I think he would do well in any team.
Su quello che invece è il ricordo che ho di quei 30 anni.
As for the last 30 years, as you mentioned, my memories of the last 30 years, I think that in life everyone must reach goals. Everyone sets goals for themselves and they have to try and reach those goals. I've always set very ambitious goals. They were so ambitious because that when I told other people about them, people would sometimes doubt that I was actually saying what I really thought, or they would doubt that they were actually possible.
When in 94
I said that I don't want the left to go get into government. And I was able to bring the Moderati to Palazzo Chigi. And when I said that with television I wanted to be Rai's main rival, people laughed back then as well. And yet I managed to do it. I want Milan to become the most successful team in the world. And with that in mind,
di un altro socio che
I have opened up
soldi
to other investors to be able to take 48% of the club, so that we can return to be as competitive as we used to be, and also open up new markets in Asia. So expand what we have been able to create so far. So I think we're on the eve of another great a great moment on the precipice of what could be a great few years to come.
Buongiorno Presidente, un saluto all'amministratore delegato, sono Adriano Gariani. Una domanda per Mr. Mihajlović.
A question for Mr. Mihajlović. What is the goal for the team and for yourself personally for this season? As I said, it's already been told. We have to win one game after another, and then we'll see where we're heading. That is the main goal.
Buongiorno, Presidente, volevo chiederle, visto che all'elenco
di giocatori si è fatto
promozione da passare al suo nuovo allenatore, visto che si è sempre scherzato lei su questa cosa, e più seriamente invece a Siniša Mihajlović volevo sapere se ha già in mente un modulo base su cui lavorare oppure se invece preferisce.
I'd like to know from Mihajlović if there is a way of playing that you already have in mind for how Milan will be playing over the season. Mihajlović. There is no one way of playing that makes you win or lose games. No formation or setup. We have to see what players we have available and how we can make them play to the best of our abilities. We have brought in two great strikers. Playing with two strikers, there aren't that many formations that we can actually revert to.
A quel punto vedremo sicuramente con I giocatori che ci sono e tutto è un modulo che si più adatta a caratteristiche che abbiamo è quello 4-3-1-2.
A 4-3-1-2 is probably the formation that suits us best at the moment. That is the starting point, and then we'll see where we go from there. We'll have time to evaluate and see if we can change that up. We'll have a formation that we'll revert to during the game as well, but I don't think there is only one way of playing, although we will start with the 4-3-1-2. I'd say we have said enough. Once again, I'd like to thank everyone for coming here today, for your attention, the attention you are giving to Milan, and I'll thank you in advance for all the good words that you will be writing and saying about Milan over the course of the season. Is there still one question?
Scusa, ma non volevo.
Nessun problema. Siete molto stati molto esaustivi. Buongiorno a tutti. Allora ne approfitto. Visto che abbiamo parlato di sistemi di giochi, I numeri lasciano un po' il tempo che trovano, ma sono importanti. E volevo
We've
chiedere.
Talked about the way that you would like to play. Let's talk about numbers, though. There are a lot of players in attack. What do you expect from players like El Shaarawy, who hasn't had an easy couple of seasons, or Bonaventura, who had a very good season last year, or Cerci, who wasn't as influential last season when he came in after January? How do you see these players fitting into your system of play? They're all very important players. They're all quality players, exceptional players, Italian players. They're young, or quite young anyway. When you have quality players, it's not really a problem, because they know how to play football, and they can adapt, and you can play them in different roles. As characteristics, I see El Shaarawy on the flank, but maybe we'll try and adapt him as a midfielder, as an internal midfielder. We'll see if he adapts to that role and whether he's actually willing to try and adapt to that role. We'll see.
Io lo vedo da sempre mediano sinistro.
Cerci, anche lui un esterno, ma
Cerci is also a player who I think plays well on the flanks, but he could play in attack as well. Bonaventura plays better as one of the three midfielders, or maybe even behind the front two. Menez can play as behind the front two or as a striker. Depends on also the opponents that you are playing against, whether you have to be more offensive or more defensive. Just wanted to ask a quick question to the president about the stadium and if there are any, if there's any new information about the stadium planned.
Voi sapete l'amore che noi tutti portiamo a San Siro, che è stato.
You all know of our love for San Siro that has been our home for so many years and of so many victories, epic victories in the last 30 years.
Quindi anche uno stadio, tra l'altro, dove si vede il calcio molto meglio che in tanti altri stadi.
And it's a stadium where you can see football being played. You can see well from all parts of the stadium. It has no running track, and so it's right on top of the pitch. It's excellent visibility. And San Siro was an excellent stadium for all the fans over the years. But now the world of football has changed. All games are showed on TV. The number of spectators has reduced, is not as high as it used to be. And all the big teams have their own stadiums. And these clubs who have built their own stadiums, all these big clubs around Europe and not only, have been able to make between 80 and 90 million euro per season from their stadiums, which is a lot of money. They're places of attraction. They're not just stadiums. There are cinemas, there are shops, there are restaurants. There are places where you can spend all day. There are museums, all kinds of things that entertain the public. Not just for the actual game itself, but for the moments before and after a match. Places where you can reach, that you should be able to reach without necessarily having to use the car as well. So where we plan to build, we're right next to two underground or metropolitan stations, metro stations, so that will be easy for the people to come to. Now, for a couple of years, whilst we're building the stadium, there may be a bit of disruption for the people who live in and around that area, a bit of disruption, but once it'll be completed, it will be a real bonus for those people, and it will also reevaluate the land and the property around the stadium. So that's the prospect, that's the vision.
Nell'ambito delle attività di una società di calcio e di uno stadio proprio.
That's why we want to build our own stadium, and I think Milan have to get with the times.
La verità, stadi meno belli di San Siro, e quindi sono stati spinti dalla necessità anche a farlo prima.
Many clubs in the past who had stadiums that weren't as good as San Siro were forced into building new stadiums. And so that's why they did it way before we did. We had a great stadium, so there was no need to do it. But now we also feel it's the right time to have our own stadium. We think it's the right time to go forward. We're waiting for the Fondazione Fiera to give us a reply, but we think that our proposal is an excellent one, and I think it will be accepted. As far as the finances are concerned, we will talk about, we'll reflect on that when the moment comes. We have various possibilities, 10 offers in fact, from other investment funds that have offered to finance the construction of the stadium. Obviously, all the specifics will have to be evaluated and decided upon once and if when we are given the go-ahead, the final go-ahead, but I have no doubt that that final go-ahead will come quite soon.
A proposito della trattativa di nuovo con Mr. B. Touchbull, c'è stato un momento a maggio, mi ricordo, davanti all'hotel in centro a Milano, in cui sembrava che la cosa fosse un po'
about Mr. B. Touchbull.
Un po' di ricerca di pubblicità da parte di qualcuno. Io volevo sapere poi che cosa invece l'ha convinta, quale aspetto di questo progetto.
What aspect of his project convinced you to sign the deal with Mr. Touchbull? The fact that China is such a big market for us.
Valutazioni sul Milan e avete lei ha individuato in Siniša le caratteristiche giuste. Ci spiega che cosa ha visto in Mihajlović?
What did you see in Mihajlović that convinced you that made you think that he was the right man for the job? Now I have to make a whole series of compliments. I have to. First of all, he's a great character, and I'm sure that he will teach our players how to take free kicks properly. He has a big personality, an important personality. He showed that last season with Sampdoria. He showed that he's capable of leading his men and being a leader. He understands football and the individual players as well. He understands technique. And he's also shown that he studies his adversaries, his opponents thoroughly, which is very important these days. Showed. And so we were convinced that he was the right man for the job after weighing up many options, even from abroad. And we're convinced that he is the best choice.
Attaccare voleva dire tenere palla.
Attacking means keeping the ball.
Con l'allenatore e con gli altri giocatori mi ero più volte lamentato.
With the coach, the previous coach, and with the players themselves, I often complained that if we were only 1-0 up or we were only leading by one goal, that the team needed to hold on to possession.
Il fatto che una volta ero riuscito a far fare ai miei ragazzi 27 passaggi successivi.
And I once told them that I saw my players doing 27 passes in a row, and then obviously the team, in order to try and get the ball back, commits a foul after 27 passes, and that is what I wanted to see a little bit more of.
Del risultato e se hai dato e se hai giocato tutto il resto della partita.
Of course, the fans want to see a victory, and if you've seen that the team control the game and take control of the football being played, then the fans are happy. The big teams, that's the way they play. You don't want to hear the coach screaming from the touchline, keep the ball, keep the ball, keep the ball.
Ne abbiamo inventata una lì, ma era un esempio, non era da adottare in maniera definitiva, il contrario che tenere palla, attaccare, attaccare, attaccare.
Now, we invented this word, attack, 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 in order as a metaphor for keeping the ball. It wasn't to be taken literally, but that was the way we wanted to the team to try and think.
Il risultato diventa un gioco assolutamente verticale.
Now, if you're losing, obviously you have to attack to try and get the game back in and try and try and turn the game around. Now, last season, we often lost leads in the last few minutes, in the last 10, 15 or even 5 minutes of the game. We would lose a lot of points because of that, and that would make that made me very unhappy. As a spectator, I was very, very disappointed and very sad to see a team that wasn't able to keep the ball towards the end of the game. Now, can I say something? The formation...
Non ho paura di confrontarmi con nessuno, no?
Now, I'm not scared of confronting anybody. I'm not afraid to talk to people in any way, not with the president who's sitting next to me. He is the best man to explain to me what Milan means and what the club, what it means to be here as the coach. He knows my courage, my grit, my determination. It is a privilege for me to be able to talk football with the president, between us two or even between us three with Mr. Galliani as well, in terms of having an exchange of opinions, but that will remain between us.
Buongiorno Presidente. Al di là della scaramanzia, perché l'altra volta è arrivato quando debuttava Allegri e quella stagione finì col tricolore. Volevo chiedere questo. Abbiamo capito che una delle scommesse sue, delle sue idee di calcio è quella di El Shaarawy centrocampista.
Now, ma comunque, I want to know, my question is,
le doti di El Shaarawy ho sempre pensato, ho sempre chiesto.
The question was about El Shaarawy and his new possible role in midfield. This gamble, and Mr. Berlusconi said it's not a gamble necessarily. We believe that he could be a very good internal midfielder, playing in a midfield of three, not the central midfielder, but the one on the left. We believe he has all the characteristics to do well in that position. Which player do you expect the most from this season? I think every player. I expect more from every player compared to last season. There are some excellent players in this squad now. Now, I have my formation in my head, if you like, the formation that maybe I would like to see playing. And I think with the arrival of Mihajlović, a lot of players can improve.
Comportamenti anche in campo, sistemi di posizionamento,
and I think a lot of players will improve on the pitch, their position, their way of playing. I am a huge fan of Menez, and I think if he is used in the right way, he is a phenomenal player. Already last season he did so much, he scored a lot of goals. But if Menez learns to be a little bit more disciplined on the pitch, especially in terms of his position and where he plays, and he can learn to become a more mature player, then he can become a really important player for Milan.
Buongiorno, una domanda al presidente. Lei ha detto che l'obiettivo è tornare in Coppa dei Campioni, vuol dire in Champions League. E i tifosi devono essere ottimisti, ma possono pensare quest'anno a vincere lo scudetto?
Assolutamente sì.
Can Milan win the scudetto? I know you said the objective was to finish in the top three, but can they win? Absolutely yes, was the answer. We know that we have an excellent foundation, and we will try to do our very best, and we I think we can, with the team that we have at the moment, with the squad we have now, we can compete for top honours with Mihajlović on board, because he has the characteristics, the qualities, to be able to compete with Juventus for first place in the league. Once again, many, many thanks. I hope to see you soon with our goals and objectives having been reached.
Con i tempi che corrono, in cui siamo tutti preoccupati del futuro, per quello che sta succedendo nel mondo, per la carenza di leadership che si è così.
I was talking in the meeting in Lega to a good friend of mine. It's worrying times in the world in general, with bad things happening, difficult times all over the world in many different respects. We have to have faith in ourselves, we have to set ambitious goals. Even during difficult times, it is possible to realise your dreams and make your dreams come true. And I hope that all of you can realise your dreams and make them come true for yourselves and for the people that you love. So, best wishes.